there's the gas valve opening. Flame sensor is sensing the flame. And now we're reading 3.2 when we were at 0.4. So just that little bit of dirt on that flame sensor can cause you to have no heat. Now on a side note, if you have to call out a serviceman to fix this, in addition to maybe them trying to sell you a furnace or God knows what else you might need, that little simple repair on a weekend, they could charge you like $300. So do me a favor, if you like the video, it's free, it doesn't cost you nothing, hit the like, subscribe button, and feel free to share this video. Leave me some comments and feedback below. I appreciate you taking the time to watch it, and we'll see you on the next one. Okay, lastly, now I got everything put back together. We're going to listen and make sure it starts. That didn't start. So this is an ARMSTRONG furnace. Also branded as an AirEase as well. Flame sensor is located right back there, and the screw for that is right there. I'm going to go ahead and test that real quick, and we'll see what the signal is, and then we'll clean it. All right, so I'm going to reach behind the gas valve here, and I'm going to take this wire off. Flame sensor, and then we're going to test it. There we go. Pull that wire right off there, so it's missing, and the flame sensor is that one on the right. The one on the left is the igniter. We're not going to mess with that. I can already see the scale build up on it, but we'll just test it just so you can see what it's reading before and after. So I've got my meter set to millivolts DC, which is what you're going to read from the flame sensor. So I hooked up one jumper wire to one lead of my meter and the other side back there to the top of the flame sensor. Flame sensor's on the bottom right in this burner. And then on the wire that I took off of it, right there, I got the other lead of the meter, so we're going to turn the furnace on and we're going to see what it's reading. I got the circuit board jumped out R to W, or I could have just turned the thermostat to the heat setting and raised the temperature on the thermostat to get it to come on, but I just saved a step. So I'm going to push in my door switch. Motor comes on, that's the first thing. It's going to cycle air through the heat exchanger, and then the next step is we're going to light that igniter on the left. And then once it lights, the gas will come on. Okay, now we're going to read the flame signal. And we want that higher, so that tells me it's dirty. So I'm going to go ahead and take my hand off the door switch, turn the power of the furnace off, and then I'm going to get back there and take the screw out of the flame sensor, and then we're going to look at that. I need a cameraman. So if you want to get over here, get back and look through the... So I'm going to use my Klein Stubby 6-in-1. And the screw is right back here. I'm going to take my jumper off. My jumper.
And there's a gas pipe in the back there, which makes it even harder. But we'll take this screw out. Oops, it's loose. Not a job for someone that's got big hands. Women can do this because their hands are smaller. But this is not coming out easy, that little screw. It's not that it's hard to get out, it's just because I don't have room for my hand. In here, let's come on, baby. A lot of people in the comments before said they couldn't, on my other video, so they couldn't see what I was taking out. And I appreciate those comments, so we're trying to get a better picture. So this is kind of hard to get my hand in there. Come on, baby, get out of there. It's tight because of the location. Just ain't want to come out. See, put a bigger. Alright. Now, if you had a little quarter-inch socket, you could put that in there possibly, and that would make it a little easier. I have those on my van, but it's not that bad. Use a little wrench. Hope I can get it out. Okay. There we go. So I'm holding the screwdriver on the head of the screw. Just to keep it in there because it's a flat head. There we go, looks like it's coming. Alright, see, that was tough. Alright, so that buildup right there is what's causing that low flame sensor reading. So we're gonna go ahead and clean it. See if I got something in my tool bag here. Should have so that's just a standard piece of steel wool. You could use a piece of Scotch-Brite. Some people use sandpaper. I'm not gonna use that, I'm just gonna use a steel wool. So I'm just going to literally just clean it like that. Make it shiny and new. Just a side note, if you use sandpaper, the glue or the adhesive that holds the sand or the abrasive on the paper will leave a residual film on the flame sensor, and that's why you don't want to use it. Some people use dollar bills. I don't do that, but now all we're going to do is put it back in so it looks like it's brand new. Another thing, I like to leave this screw in there because it's kind of hard to fish back there because I got a gas pipe kind of in my way. So let's see. And then that way it'll help find that hole it's going into back here. And if you see, I'm just going to spin that around, it'll drop right in the hole there, just like that. And then now I'm gonna just
get that with the screwdriver.
Now this screw, for some reason, is just there's a small furnace, so there's not a lot of room for me, and I've got big hands, so definitely going in easier this time than it did coming out. I want to make sure that's tight because that needs a good ground contact in order to sense the flame, so it's nice and tight. So I'm just going to reverse the process. I got my meter, and here's the deal. If you're just a homeowner, you don't have to have a meter, but this is how your trained professional would come over and check it and make sure that it was clean, there wasn't other problems. Sometimes the porcelain could get cracked, not very likely. This part you can actually buy on Amazon if you know the manufacturer of your furnace. But I'm going to literally just put my jumper wire on the other side of this, top of that. Hand in there. Now, this is not as hard as you think, but you just break out it. So let me just click. And another side note, you can't ever clean the flame, the igniter. Don't make that mistake because you'll ruin it and then you really have big problems. Alright, so I got that open and I got that on there. I'm going to turn the power back on the furnace. I already got the heat jumped out. And now we're going to see what the flame sensor reads. So once again, we got the draft motor's going to start up. Once that cycles, then the hot surface igniter is going to light if the pressure switch is made. And then there's a gas valve opening. Flame sensor is sensing the flame. And now we're reading 3.2 when we were at 0.4. So just that little bit of dirt on that flame sensor can cause you to have no heat. Now on a side note, if you have to call out a serviceman to fix this, in addition to maybe them trying to sell you a furnace or God knows what else you might need, that little simple repair on a weekend, they could charge you like $300. So do me a favor, if you like the video, it's free, it doesn't cost you nothing, hit the like, subscribe button, and feel free to share this video. Leave me some comments and feedback below. I appreciate you taking the time to watch it, and we'll see you on the next one. So another thing, after I cleaned and put everything back together, I like to cycle the furnace from the thermostat a couple times on and off, just to verify that there's no additional problems while I'm here. One of the things that I noticed is that when I was testing the flame sensor, then I shut it off by the door switch, it overheated the high limit, so then it went into a lockout, so then I had to turn the fan on the furnace in order to get the limit to cool off. Once I did that, I checked it two more times from the thermostat, so I'm going to turn it off at this point and set the temperature to what it was set at when I got here.